Here with Coach Brett Bonneau. Coach, you faced two of the best pitchers in the Lone Star Conference today, and I thought they lived up to the billing. What do you think about Feckley and Weatherly today?
Well, I thought they were very consistent with their off-speed pitches, which kept us off balance a little bit, and we just weren't able to match them when it came to them putting up a crooked number. And when you give those guys a lead and you have those two guys on the mound, it's just hard to come back and get things going. We had some opportunities, though, with runners in scoring position, just didn't get the hits when we needed them. But we had just had two bad innings. We had the first inning of game one. We gave up a three spot, didn't give up any more runs after that, but couldn't get anything going. And then, in inning five or inning four, I think we gave up four runs and, just separated them. And with their defense, the way they're playing right now and the way our offense is going, it's just we couldn't get back into the game.
But Austin Palmer, I haven't seen every game he's pitched this year, but this looked like, if not his best, one of his best. The three runs he gave up in the first, I don't think they hit a ball hard. In fact, he gave up six singles, and none of them really were that hard hit. I thought he pitched great. What'd you think about Austin?
Well, after that first inning, he really got ahead, and when you started getting the first guy out. And when you do that, and it looked like he kind of calmed down and was able to throw his off-speed pitches. And when he had two off-speed pitches working, he got through the last six innings pretty quick, and that's a good sign.
Very good.
Going into a tournament that you're going to need good starting pitching, and when you have a guy like that that's kind of went out there and after a rough first inning, kind of figures things out, and he went out there and pitched a great game. I thought he pitched a great game and gave us a chance to win it, and we just didn't come up with the right hits when we needed them.
In control as well, I think he may have hit a batter. I don't think he walked a batter. It was really
right.
Good controlling.
And that's one thing that he struggled with this year, and to have a good outing right there before we go into a conference tournament builds up his confidence, and we really need that going into that tournament if we're going to win it.
Carter, you mentioned the four spot he gave up top five, and they wound up losing 6-1. Does the pressure accumulate on a pitcher when an offense is struggling?
Well, I mean, it doesn't help, you know. I mean, you saw what happened on Friday night when we were starting to swing the bat and we score some. When that happens, the pitchers are able to go out there and relax a little bit, and obviously Lambeau did his job and did his part at the end. And so we need to hit better. We need to hit with runners in scoring position and get our leadoff guy on and then be able to produce some runs for them.
Any concern? He's faced two good hitting teams, Tarleton and Angelo State, but after really dominating a lot, his last two starts have been a little off for Carter.
Well, I mean, again, he's also had to go against their number one.
Right.
And so that's a tough task, but
we
have a lot of confidence in him. He's a workhorse. He can go late in the game. And, again, we're going to need a guy like that going into the conference tournament. So far, we're real pleased with our starters that we've been throwing out there. Again, we just got to, one, continue to play good defense behind him, which we have, and then, two, get a couple more hits. And if we can get that going, there's some things that we can do.
You going to go with Ty Taylor tomorrow?
Ty Taylor tomorrow, yep. And he's thrown some great outings for us the last three.
Yes.
And that's against some good hitting teams. And so we're expecting him to go out there and give us another great outing.